acts like he has a dream, full of passion.
Knock niggas out the box all the time.
Senator Joseph Biden may have more explaining to do.
But this time it's for the uninvited. Go ahead and rhyme to it. Big nigga Mike's is getting fired. But this time it's for the uninvited.
The new questions stem from taped remarks of Biden during an April campaign appearance in New Hampshire.
I went to law school on a full academic scholarship, the only one in my class to have a full academic scholarship. Went back to law school and in fact ended up in the top half of my class. I was the outstanding student in the political science department at the end of my year. I graduated with 3 degrees from undergraduate school and 165 credits, only needed 123 credits.
Biden now concedes he did not graduate in the top half of his law school class, that he does not have 3 degrees from college, and that he was not named outstanding political science student in college.
Newsweek says Biden actually went to school on a half scholarship, ended up near the bottom of his class, and won only 1 degree, not 3.
Joe Biden ranked 76th in a class of 85 at the University of Syracuse Law School. I mean, this guy comes off this whole thing as a flyweight.
Now Biden says Newsweek is right. His memory had failed him.
And I'd be delighted to sit down and compare my IQ to yours if you'd like, Frank.
Joe Biden was victimized by the truth.
Bye-bye Biden. He may not know it yet, but I think this is going to be very difficult for him to recover.
Is Joe Biden dead meat, yes or no?
I think so.
Bob.
Terminal condition.
Terminal. Eleanor.
Yes, unless he comes in third in Iowa.
Morton.
Dying.
I say dead. We'll be right back.
Bye-bye Biden. He may not know it yet, but I think this is going to be very difficult for him to recover.
Is Joe Biden dead meat, yes or no?
I think so.
Bob.
Terminal.
Terminal. Eleanor.
Yes, unless he comes in third in Iowa.
More
time. Dying.
I say dead. We'll be right back.
Congresswoman Gabbard, you took issue with Senator Harris confronting Vice President Biden at the last debate. You called it a, quote, false accusation that Joe Biden is a racist. What's your response?
I want to bring the conversation back to the broken criminal justice system that is disproportionately negatively impacting black and brown people all across this country today. She put over 1,500 people in jail for marijuana violations and laughed about it when she was asked if she ever smoked marijuana. She blocked evidence that would have freed an innocent man from death row.
Listen up now, this is serious. When you're tempted to do something wrong, even if the reasons are good, think twice, because you never know how things will turn out. You might be getting yourself and everybody else into a whole lot of trouble. Do what's right, and you can't go wrong. Give me one good reason,
baby, come on. Draft Jesse People won. They had, you know, a total of 9 votes. Yeah, this was not a very well-attended election. We're going to talk about that in a moment, yeah? There were 3 votes for Tulsi, and there was no votes for anyone else. No one, yeah? So let's talk about why this happened. So the thing is that we can see that one of the common critiques of MPP is that they are not actually doing anything to actually, you know, bring about change now, that they're willing to settle for Biden, which we know is a very corporatist leader, especially with the signaling that he's doing by putting Kamala Harris as VP. So we can see that the time is really more critical than ever, right? COVID, all these other problems, right? We can see that the time is very critical, and the time for us to consolidate and to make power moves is now, yeah? 4 years from now, they're gonna try to get us to accept the same bad deal. They've been playing this game for a long time. But, you know, I gave these organizations a way out. I also sent my message out to many progressive, you know, newscasters, as well as, you know, a lot of different political organizations and parties. Now, the thing is that usually you guys see me more active on Facebook and Twitter and stuff like that, but to tell you the truth, you know, either it's a weird circumstance, you know. Now, when you put in a lot of years in the game, the circumstances, honestly, I think this is a circumstance, but, you know, a lot of people out there sometimes laugh and say, you know, different stupid things like, you know, oh, you think this is a conspiracy theory. Sometimes it obviously is, and these people have done no work to actually do any research. You'll actually see on my channel, right, actually the results of the election could have been contested, yeah? Because the thing is that I kind of threw my weight behind Yang, Yeah, in the end I voted for Tulsi, but you know, you could see that all my language and stuff, I was really pushing the Yang people to come out. You know, the Graf Chessy people were doing well before, right? I'm guilty of this too. No one's innocent here, right? Yeah? I thought that I did not understand the strength of the or the commitment of the Graf Chessy people. And I actually, thought that Yang Gang should win. I saw that they had the bike parade, which I participated in. Right, I saw other actions that showed me that they were the forces on with the ability and the ground game to make actual change happen, which was great. Yeah, you can see the Yang Gang had actually significant presence within MPP's events, ever since July, right? Yeah? Okay, yeah, because they can. Yeah, some organizations cannot bring those numbers, cannot bring those goods to the table, like 10,000 signatures asking for UBI, things like that, right? Yeah, very powerful stuff here. But the thing is that really, right, remember I said earlier that I had sent my email out to many political organizations and also to news groups? But the thing is that honestly, my message is undergoing a progressive media blackout. I'm asking myself a question. Does Yang Gang have the commitment? Do they have the perspective? Do they have the willingness to sacrifice in the ways that it will take to win in the big ways? Yeah? Or will they, when confronted with, some amount of resistance, will they let people that are, whether their message is, I completely believe in my message, you heard it right, yeah, it's for democracy, it's for, creating a coalition of the right and the left, a true people's party. Yeah? That's all I'm asking for here. I'm not asking to be made president, I'm not asking for money, right? I'm just asking for democracy. Yeah, that's all. So, Yang Gang, I love you to death, but Draft Jesse seems like they're a little bit more hungry for it right now. And that's the record that you decided to leave for all the other organizations that I contacted, right, as in terms of saying, right, like, this is the evidence of the ability to mobilize, evidence of the ability of you to speak to your political strength. Now, because of Yang Gang has a strong ground operation, they were, they are really, they could have won this. They won the pre-one on the Twitter, yeah? If you want to be a pioneer in this space, life isn't going to be easy. People who are frontiersmen, people who are on that particular edge, right here, I'm on the edge of trying to bring about the societal change that we need to survive. No more of this kind of like it's someone else's problem, I'm gonna pass the buck down the road. No more of this, right, making deals, yeah, right? I'm going to go all the way with this. And that's why you guys watch this channel, because you know what I'm about, yeah? And the Jesse people actually overcame, right, my, I fixed the elections a little bit, yeah? Honestly, promoting Tulsi all the time and fucking waving Yang Gang around, right? I didn't say that much about Jesse at all, yeah? But they constantly came in and exceeded expectations. The Draft Jesse people, people in Draft Jesse, I'm going to be exploring more into their organization real soon because they are effective and they don't give a fuck. They're ready to do it, yeah? Yang Gang, I love you guys. I'm going to have to pull back a little bit on my work with you guys, yeah? I'm sorry, but if you guys do not have the willpower, if you do not have the conviction to carry through all the way and take advantages where you can and fight for the people, notice that once again, right, my video very recently of, why I folded up the Tulsi flag talks about my commitment to the people, yeah, right, if Tulsi, you know what I mean, I love Tulsi to death, but, if I gotta fold her face up, even though she's one of the first, proponents for UBI in a public way, right, besides Yang, she came out and she took that, I'm sure the establishment doesn't like that either, yeah, they don't want someone legitimizing an outsider's message, you know what I mean, so, even though she was the first one to do it, because it's just straight up a fucking good idea, you know what I mean? Because of the horrible propaganda out there, I had to make a fucking compromise. And I had to silence Tulsi and, for the good of the event. So it's not like I don't understand what Yang Gang's doing, and I love them to death. But, honestly, we're taking on all the forces of the establishment. We're taking on the whole system, yeah? I'm gonna still work with Yang Gang. But I want you to take this journey with me and explore these Draft Jesse people if you're kind of hardcore and you want to explore what that's all about, yeah? Yang Gang, I believe in his ideas. I think he's a great guy and I'm down to support the platform and I will not turn my back on Yang Gang. But if the Yang Gang, the Tulsi crew,
three votes. They're people that I've been personally involved with. I can't give them that community. Right there, they had my back. Right, the people. There's me, Lisa. You know Lisa. You know, yeah.
And you're making a big mistake if you expect folks to be something that they are not. A whole town full of folks hated all Indians and all red ferns for 75 years. They thought all Indians were alike, and that ignorance caused them to suffer and make them look stupid. So don't ever judge somebody for what they are, but who they are. And when you meet them, don't expect them to be. Let them be.
It's a dark day in our nation when high-level authorities will seek to use every method to silence dissent. The truth must be told.
And if you want the truth, you need to check out independent media producers just like myself, DJL7. You should subscribe and hit the bell icon to get notifications when I release a new video.
The truth of these words is beyond doubt.
That includes Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, and of course YouTube. Unfortunately, we have definitely seen that these mainstream outlets will cave to corporate interests, so we encourage you to join our independently moderated communities of Reddit and Discord. We also encourage you to subscribe to us on BitChute and Daily Motion so you can see the content that YouTube doesn't want us to let you see. Hey, now it's time for the most important part of the video. That's right, it's time for us to tell you about the Taking Action Group. Do you need an activist? Or maybe there's no activists around willing to help with your cause and you need to learn to become an activist. That's exactly why we're here. Every week, we get up with people from across the nation, in fact, even sometimes internationally, and we develop strategies and a game plan to address the issues that are affecting all of us. Every week, myself from New York City and, of course, my co-host Lisa from Los Angeles provide a coast-to-coast perspective on what's going on in the country. If you want to donate to help out with expenses, travel, equipment, you know, stuff like that, then I definitely appreciate it, and you can hit us off at Venmo or PayPal. Thanks a lot. Hey, by the way, we also have a merch store, so check it out. Oh my goodness, it seems like you've reached the end of the video, so make sure you check out some of our other videos. Make sure you subscribe. This is your last chance to do so, so thanks a lot. And looking forward to seeing you on the next one. Hope you guys enjoyed. Please comment below if you have any questions or issues you'd like me to address. And if you're an activist, the time to make things happen is now.